Blessed good evening and welcome to Festival of Pentecost Weekend 2021 under our theme Empowered. And this evening is traditionally known as Worship and Warfare. And we've come to intercede and we've come to learn of the work of the Holy Spirit in intercession this evening. A blessed good evening to each and every one of you who are here in the house and those of you joining on the various Facebook pages. I want to say a blessed good evening to Elder Ronald Odell, the pastor of the house. I want to say thanks to you, sir, and your staff and all of those that work with you in making the house available this evening for this night of intercession. I want to give a special thanks to Akeem and his team for working song and tech. And we will all come together this evening under one umbrella, that is the umbrella of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So shall we stand this evening as we prepare our hearts to enter into a time of worship and song, and then we will move from that straight into a time of teaching by Minister Shernell Williams, and then from that straight into a time of intercession. There will be no emceeing this evening. We will be just flowing from one thing to the other, and so we've come to give God praise. So right where you are, whether you are at home, whether you are in the car, but if you are driving, don't do this though, but if you're not driving, lift your hands. If you're seated in a passenger seat, if you're in your kitchen, wherever you are, just lift your hands and just begin to thank the Lord. It has been a tough week for many of us. To be quite honest, it has been even a challenging week, even in terms of pulling logistics together for this festival. But this festival is not about a particular church. It is not about a denomination. It is not about a person or a personality. It is not about pastors, reverends, bishops, and apostles. This festival is for us to celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit and to welcome Him among our midst so that He can have His free reign in our lives, in the churches that He has placed us in, so that we can make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So right where you are, even if you're in a mass, wherever you are, can we begin to just adore Daddy God? Can we just begin to just worship Him? Can we tell Him how wonderful He is? Can we lay all of our cares and frustrations and all of our issues at the feet of the cross and declare that our God is supreme? He is worthy of all praise. He is worthy of all glory. He is worthy of all honor. And we have come to worship You this evening, Lord. God, we make this worship personal. God, we move it from the realm of what we know. And God, I've come to say that I, Kevin, I thank You for Your mercy. I thank You for Your great grace. I thank You for the blood of Jesus Christ. I thank You for the gift of the Holy Spirit. I thank You for forgiving me. I thank You for washing me. I thank You for strengthening me. I thank You for delivering me, Lord. And God, I know all of my brothers and sisters have said the same thing. And so, Lord God, we join our hearts and we join our minds now and we declare, God, to You be the glory, to You be the honor, that You will be lifted up, You will be magnified. And so, Father, anoint Minister Shernell, anoint every minister of music, every minister of the instruments, anoint the song team and the multimedia team, every person who will lift up and offer prayers. Lord, let us come on the one anointing this evening, the anointing of the Holy Spirit, for there is one body and one God and one Spirit who rules all under the lordship of one Christ, and His name is Jesus. And so, God, be magnified this evening, be glorified this evening, be exalted in all that we say and all that we do, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, lift your hands in His presence. The Lord reigns. Let the earth rejoice this evening. He reigns. He rules. He is majestic in all the earth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He is our God. He is our King. He is the sovereign. Come on, open your mouths and just worship Him. Open your mouths and just give Him praise. He alone is worthy. He stretched out the heavens like a canopy. Hallelujah. Come on, He laid the foundations of the world and He covered it with the deep. He is great and greatly to be praised. Come on, we just want to draw close to Him this evening. Come on, and let His peace reign over our lives this evening. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, we just want to worship.
We want to worship. Give you praise.
Thank you, Jesus. We just want to draw close to him this evening. And let his peace reign over our lives. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Father of life, draw me closer. Lord, my heart is set on you. Let me run the race of time with your life unfold in mine. And let the peace of God let it rain. Father of life, draw me closer. Lord, my heart is set on you. Let me run the race of time with your life unfold in mine, and let the peace of God let it rain. Oh Lord, I hunger for more of you. Rise up within me, let me know your truth. Oh, God, let it rain. Oh, Holy Spirit, you're my comfort. Strengthen me, hold my head up high as I stand upon your truth, bringing glory unto you. Of God, let it rain. Oh Lord, I hunger for more of you. Rise up within me, let me know your truth. Oh Holy Spirit, saturate my soul. Let it rain. Oh Lord, I hunger for more of you. Rise up within me, let me know your truth. Oh Holy Spirit, saturate my soul. Healing power, breathe life and make me whole, and let the peace of God let it rain. Fill me now, let your healing power breathe life and make me whole, and let the peace of God. Let it rain. Fill me now. Let your healing power breathe life and make me whole. And let the peace of God let it rain. Oh, Lord, I hunger
for more of you.
Rise up within me.
Let me know your truth.
Holy Spirit,
saturate my soul. Of God, let it rain. Fill me now. Let your healing power breathe life and make me whole. And let the peace of God, let it rain. Oh Lord, I hunger for more. My soul, and let the light of God fill me now. Let your healing power breathe life and make me whole. And let the peace of God, let it rain. Oh Lord, I hunger for more. Your truth.
Oh, Holy Spirit,
saturate my soul and let the life of God fill me now. Let your healing power breathe life and make me whole and let the peace of God. Let it rain.
Fill me now.
Let your healing power breathe life and make me whole. And let the peace of God let it rain. Fill me now. Let your healing power breathe life and make me whole. And let the peace of God let it rain. Hallelujah.
Rain, oh God.
Hallelujah. Oh God. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Fill us again, Lord. Fill us again, oh God. Fill us again, mighty God. For you're the only God, you're the only God. There's none like you, Lord. There's none like you. We worship you, Lord. You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, Lord. You're glorious, Lord. You're glorious, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Glorious Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah, yes. We give you glory, Lord.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There is only one name, amen. There is only one name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is only one name with power to save. There's only one name. Oh.
There is only one name with power to save. With power to save.
There is only one name.
There is only one. He reigns.
Hallelujah. He's champion. And he reigns forever and ever and ever and ever. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody needs to be reminded that he is our champion. You might feel as if no one is fighting your cause or no one is fighting on your behalf. But the one who is the ruler of heaven and earth, the one who breathed out the stars, the one who said, let it be, and there was, the God who is so big, yet so small that he comes and he dwells on the inside of us, that God, the one who took our sins upon his own body, the one who allowed himself to be planted in the womb of a sinful lady, because we are all born in sin. The one who allowed himself to be nailed on a tree that he created and allowed his creation to beat him so that he can take captivity, death, hell, and the grave. That same God is fighting for you. He is our champion. And his is a championship that does not come to an end. But he is champion forever and ever and ever and ever and ever, which means that the cause that you need a champion for, when that cause is over, he is still going to be champion. And we give him praise and we give him glory and we give him honor this evening, for he is worthy of all praise. He is worthy of all glory. He is worthy of all the honor. He is worthy to be magnified, because he is champion. He is king. He is Lord God Almighty. He is the Lord God strong in battle. He is Lord Sabaoth. He is El Rohi. He is the one who fights on our behalf. And we give him praise this evening. Our God is champion. Hallelujah. Coming to speak to us for a few moments now is Minister Chernell Williams from New Dimensions Ministries. And so you may be seated as we hear the word of the Lord. Welcome, Minister Chernell.
Thank you. Amen, amen, amen. Good evening, church, and good evening to those online as well joining us. Good evening to my esteemed apostles, pastors, ministers of the house, and especially the elder of this house, Elder Ronald Odell. Good evening. Good evening again. Phil Wickham sings a song, "This is the start of something amazing." That in our hearts we are waiting for something that's far beyond what we have seen or heard. And that we're fixing our eyes on glory and fire. And truly, this weekend, starting this evening, it's all about that. Amen. This weekend commemorates one of the key events in the history of Christianity and the church. And I am truly honored and unbelievably humbled to have been given this opportunity by Pastor Kevin and his team to speak to you at the start of what I consider to be a great celebration. And I pray that Holy Spirit will make his presence very real and very tangible in our midst. Not only as I speak to you, but throughout this evening and this weekend. And I also pray that our hearts will be open to receive and to apply all that he will say to us as we make room for him to move in every aspect of our lives once again, be it individually, corporately, nationally, or regionally, or even globally. Let's make room this evening. Amen. So I'm to speak to you on the role and the power of the Holy Spirit in intercession and warfare. Long title, but I'll make it simple. And our key text this evening is Ephesians 6, verse 18. And I'm using the Amplified Version. With all prayer and petition, pray with specific requests at all times, on every occasion, and in every season, in the Spirit. And with this in view, stay alert with all perseverance and petition, interceding in prayer for all God's people. Now, just to give context, Ephesians 6:18 is Paul, after going through various instructions for family and work relationships, from verse 10, Paul starts talking about the armor of God and identifies who we are really fighting against when it comes to spiritual warfare. Now, at first glance, it might seem that after talking about the various pieces of armor and their purposes, he suddenly switches to a whole different subject in verse 18. But in actual fact, it's as though he's putting a full stop or summing up all that he's just saying by concluding with the exhortation to pray in the Spirit. So the question that we should ask ourselves is, why? If we're going to wage an effective and strategic warfare, if we're going to hit the target each time, that bullseye pinpoint accuracy, if we're going to come out victorious, beloved, we need to pray in the Spirit. But what does that look like? Is it just stirring up ourselves, speaking in tongues? Is it the shouting, weeping, and emotional display that some persons make it? And don't get me wrong, I'm not knocking these things. But my question is it just these things or mainly these things? Can our prayers be effective and produce great, marvelous results? And if the answer is a resounding, emphatic yes, then is there some secret or some formula that we use when we pray? Let's look at it. Here's what the Word of God tells us. Pray in the Spirit. A small word in, those who are English people, preposition, tremendous meaning and value used here in context. Think of it like this in relation to water or the river, or our river, or seeing that we're in the Caribbean, the sea. I'm in the water, immersed in it, and I'm also being carried along by the water if I yield to its currents and movements. And what is one of the symbols of the Holy Spirit again? Water. So it's the water that is predominantly controlling me, its currents and its waves as it goes out and as it comes in. This is like us and the Spirit when it comes to prayer. His currents, his waves that come in, move upon us mightily and powerfully, producing his results. But I'm going to come back to this a little bit later, because there's a balance, yeah? So when it comes to prayer, especially corporate or organized prayer like we have here this evening, whether it's in a group or with someone else, we ought to approach it having the mindset and heart's posture that is first and foremost his agenda, not ours. We are simply partnering with him to birth what he wants, birth in this realm. We are in the water, carried by the water. And we must see ourselves simply as vessels, no more, no less. We partner with him, as Galatians 5:25 using the NIV says. We stay in step with him. We keep in step with him. We yield our ideas, our thoughts, our methodologies to him and fully submit, partnering our all, our voice speaking what he wants declared and said aloud, because we understand the principle of the power of our words, life and death. Proverbs 18, verse 21. We understand that because we are now sons of God, joint heirs of Jesus Christ, seated together with him in heavenly places, and he has given us full delegated authority, man. Our words are now filled with the full power, authority, and weight as his words. So it means that our words, they now become spirit and life as well. Amen? So it's absolutely incumbent or binding upon us to ensure that in our praying and our intercession at all times, beloved, not sometimes, but at all times, we are praying in the Spirit. And I dare say not just when we're praying either, but period. Because honestly, it's beyond me how we pray about something and then we get up and before we're couple miles down the road, we start in our conversation, we start tearing and speaking the same things that we were just bombarding heaven about. It's we shooting ourselves in the foot. It does not make sense. These things ought not to be. Jeremiah 1, 9 to 10 says, then the Lord reached out and touched my mouth and said, look, I have put my words in your mouth. Today I appoint you to stand up against nations and kingdoms. Some you must uproot and tear down. Note carefully. Some you must uproot and tear down, destroy and overthrow. Others you must build up and plant. So because the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth, who takes from the counsel of the Godhead and tells it to us, John 15, 26 and chapter 16, verse 13, it's there. We need to approach prayer with this attitude. Yes, I understand that there must be a need for prayer points in settings such as this sometimes. But there must also needs be an attitude that even with the points, what is the mind and heart and will of the Father? And who knows these things so that he can tell them to us? 1 Corinthians 2, 10 to 12. God revealed these things by his Spirit. For his Spirit searches out everything and shows us God's deep secrets. So it's the Spirit of God that gives us the understanding and the revelation and the insight that shows us how to pray. He is the Spirit of wisdom and revelation. He teaches and he gives strategy. So that means, therefore, that we come not having a formula of verses or prayer, but understanding that God always gives different strategies every time for warfare. Check it out. 2 Samuel 5, 19 to 23. Two victories against the Philistines. 1 Samuel 30, Ziklag, and on and on. And each time, David would cry out to God, this man who said, Lord, don't take your Holy Spirit away from me, he would cry out asking God for directions, for strategy. In 1 Kings 20, the Arameans thought that they would fight against the Israelites on the plains and win because it seemed to them that the God of the Israelites was only a God of the hills. And that's why they were getting a resounding defeat at the hands of the Israelites. But God clearly stated, so that they may know I am God of hills and valleys. And so therefore, a small army that is described as two flocks of goats, kill 100,000 men in one day. Is it no wonder that the Lord proclaims in Zechariah 4, 6, man, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit. Amen? It is about his strategies. His strategies, beloved. The Lord prayer serves as a model. Yes. Nothing else. That's it. And as one author wrote, Christ, while on earth, taught his disciples how to pray. And today he's teaching the same lesson by means of the comforter or helper. Then it was by outward form. But now it was by inward guidance. So the Lord's Prayer isn't meant to be some ritualistic six-step formula. Yeah, if we're going to take a formula from it, then let it be about brevity. Amen? Pray in the Spirit. Amen? One of the great, invigorating, wonderful, and I am talking from experience, one of the great, invigorating, wonderful joys that I love of praying in the Spirit is that it's an adventure. I don't know about you, but my husband will tell you I'm a little crazy, and I love adventures to his detriment sometimes. But the Holy Spirit, he gives insight and revelation, as I said before, as we allow him to lead, as we keep in step with him. Prophetic declarations and prayer flow without thinking from us. We learn as he imparts knowledge to us. As he uses his sword, the word, in such a way that honestly, I don't know about you, but my mouth is left drop open as he applies it as only he can to what we're praying about. He brings up images and he draws on real life circumstances as analogies and uses them to pray through us what he wants done. This is the power of praying in the Spirit. This is how we produce, not the actual physical, but similar to Acts 4, verse 31. After they prayed, the place where they were meeting was shaken. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. And here are the results. And spoke the word of God boldly. Boldly. It's an awesome adventure, I tell you. An awesome adventure to allow him to guide us in our prayer. And then my fourth point is this. The Holy Spirit is about order and protocol. Yes, he is. Earlier, I mentioned being immersed in the water and carried along by its flow or currents. And I compared that to us praying in the Spirit and being carried along by his flow and currents. And yes, we have what is known as nabi in the Hebrew for that bubbling up, that gushing forth. That's like being swept along by a mighty rushing force. And yes, we will experience this as we pray in the Spirit. But let me remind us again, the Holy Spirit is about order and protocol. Read 1 Corinthians 14 carefully again and see the correction and order that Paul was bringing to this church who was fluent in the gifts of the Spirit. Yeah, you see, no one person has the entire picture or has the situation nailed down. So in a setting such as this or in prayer groups, each person's part is relevant and necessary. It's a community thing, not a one-man show. So don't try to pray all when it's your turn. Trust and rely on the fact that if you've been given 5 minutes, then stick to that as much as possible. And ask the Holy Spirit to help you and trust that he will. If you sincerely go over, and believe you me, I do know that it can happen, let it be that it was evident to everyone present, especially your leaders and those in charge, that there was such a flow that shouldn't be broken, and so grace was extended to you. But this should, however, be the exception and not the norm every time you come to pray. Let your reputation be one of someone who is truly slow to speak, as in having few words and not the other way around. Let's not forget that Proverbs 10:19 says that sin is not lacking in the multitude of words, and he who restrains his lips is wise. So when I keep going on and on, because after all, I know how to pray, and I've been at this for years, and I move away from praying in the Spirit, and I'm now praying in my flesh, is that not sin? Let's remember this clear caution and admonition in 1 Corinthians 14:32 to 34, one that I myself am subject to this evening. The spirits of the prophets are subject to the prophet. And let us not forget that the fruit of the Holy Spirit, part of the fruit of the Holy Spirit is self-control. And let's exercise that at all times and in all things. And I love how Maya Perlman puts it this way. The lightning that rends trees, burns houses, and destroys people is of the same nature as the electricity that operates so smoothly through a powerhouse. The difference is in the matter of control. So listen, if the Holy Spirit gives you a few words, pray them, beloved, and pray them sincerely. 5 words prayed in the Spirit are far more beautiful, more powerful, more effective, and accomplishes far greater than 100 words prayed out of rote and intellect and completely lacking anointing. It's not about our command of the English language or what great speaking skills we may have. We can't force God's hand. It's the power and the anointing that is being released in atmosphere out of sincere spirit-infused prayer. And sometimes the person praying is completely unaware of the impact because they're just focused on one person. One person. And that leads me to my fifth and final point. The Holy Spirit, he glorifies the Son. A man praying in the Spirit is not praying for applause or amens of approval. His focus is completely on an audience of one and one person only. There's a mental, and I dare say, a spiritual closet that he enters into and closes the door where it's just him and his favorite one, because it's spirit praying through him to the only one who is worthy. We often quote James 5:16, and we stress on the latter part of that verse. I think maybe, I don't know, totally ignoring and missing the connection and prerequisite to the first half of that verse, as well as the context of that verse. We zero in on the effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much, stressing on the fervency, the passion, the shouting, the emotion, as though that determines the effectiveness. And we totally miss that the emphasis, the key, is on the righteousness of the one praying. We forget the prerequisite that James gives of essentially having clean hands and a pure heart so that our prayers can be heard. Certainly, if fervency was a measurement, the tax collector in Luke 18:13 would have gone away ignored, and the thief on the cross would have died a sinner because their prayers weren't fervent and worked up. And I'm not knocking, don't get me wrong, I'm not knocking the fervency, but let's not make it about that. Yeah? I have this 11-year-old that I'm privileged. He looks to me as a mom. And I remember one day he was praying for me. And, you know, 11-year-olds, shy, don't really want to pray. But his prayer made me weep like a child. Simple and brief. But the sincerity that came out as he prayed for me, you knew it was God was hearing this prayer. Yeah? Let us come like children. Like children. So the Holy Spirit, who is also called the Spirit of Christ, is of incomparable humility. And in fact, he shares this attribute of himself with us, imparting it to us. So when we come, let's not be like those Jesus mentioned in Matthew 6, 5, and 7. Let's come according to Ephesians 4, 2 to 3, always being humble and gentle, being patient with each other, making allowance for each other's faults because of our love. Let's make every effort to keep ourselves united in the Spirit, binding ourselves together with peace. This, beloved, is the role and power of the Holy Spirit in intercession and warfare. If you want a secret, this is the secret or the formula of effective mountain-moving prayer. So as we get ready to go into a time of intercession and warfare, let us remember 2 Corinthians 3:5. Not that we are competent in ourselves to claim anything that comes from us, but our competency comes from God. And Romans 8:26, in the same way, the Spirit comes and helps us in our weakness. We do not know what prayer to offer or how to offer it as we should, but the Spirit himself, he knows our need and he intercedes on our behalf. And like I said earlier, let us come with an Acts 4:31 expectancy as well. Not necessarily to shake this building, God in his wisdom, but certainly to shake the spiritual environs of this district, this nation, and beyond, that his presence be quite real and tangible as we pray, and even after we leave this place, as though we leave a deposit here for services coming after, because we have understood what it means to pray in the Spirit. Amen? Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Minister Chernow. So let's stand a minute, please. And if you can, and if you're able, even those of you who are at home, if we can join with those who will be leading in intercession, in prayer. But before we do that, can we just take a minute after the Lord has spoken to us just now? And ask the Holy Spirit to search our hearts. Ask him to cleanse us from any transgression. Ask him to purify our vessels. Purify our minds, purify our hearts. And then ask him to lead and direct every prayer that will be offered. So cleanse us, God. Purify us this evening for you are worthy. Thank you, Jesus. And Holy Spirit, lead us as we intercede now for our nation. Guide us. Help us to pray with one mind, one heart. Hallelujah, one purpose. And after we pray for our nation, God, lead us as we pray for the church. And then for families. And then for this COVID-19 situation. We thank you this evening.
First Timothy 2:1-4. First of all, I urge that petition, prayer, intercession, and thanksgiving be offered up for all people, for kings and all who are in high authority, so that we may live a peaceful and quiet life in all godliness and dignity. This is good and pleases God, our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. Father, we thank you for Barbados, this island that is so uniquely positioned, oh God. We just thank you, oh God, that we are also part of these Isles of the Sea who are going to sing your praises, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for the government of Barbados. We thank you for those men and women who are committed to serving this nation, oh God. We thank you, oh God. God, even right now, I declare, oh God, bring to their memory, oh God. Bring to their memory their childhood, oh God, when they were in your word, oh God. They were taught your word, oh God. Bring to their memory, oh God, when they decided, oh God, to be politician and servants of this nation. Bring to their memory, oh God, that my father, when they made the oath, they made the oath on your word to protect this nation, oh God. They made that oath on your word, oh God, to take care of this nation business, oh God. They made an oath on your word to do all that they need to do for this nation, oh God. So, Father, I thank you. I thank you even now, oh God, that you are beginning a stirring, oh God, in their lives, oh God. I declare, oh God, that there will come to the place, oh God, where they know you as God, oh God, where they would be able to hear from your word, oh God, where they would be able to speak not of flesh, oh God, but will speak of your word, oh God, speak what you are calling them to say, oh God. Father, I bring before you our Prime Minister, Mia Amor-Motley, oh God. God, I thank you, oh God, for her. God, being a Prime Minister of a nation is not easy, oh God. So much responsibility, oh God. So much decision to be made, oh God. But God, I pray that she would make those decisions, oh God, in wisdom. And not in her wisdom, oh God, but in your wisdom, oh God. May she surround herself with godly people, oh God. People of truth, oh God. People who know you, oh God. People of integrity, oh God. People that are honest, oh God. People that have no agenda but God's agenda. May she surround them and take godly counsel, oh God. God, I pray that she would understand that this responsibility is not only hers to carry, oh God. There is a burden bearer, oh God, who asks us to cast our cares upon him. And he, oh God, will answer. He will take care. He will respond. May she cast all her cares on him because he's ready. He's a God that loves with so much passion, oh God. He loves her more than she would understand, oh God. May she, oh God, be wise. May she be wise and look to the God who is God all by himself, who is the creator of heaven and earth. He is the one, and may she remember that it's only because of this God that this nation, Barbados, has come this far. Yeah. And it's only with this God that we will go forth and do all that he has called us to do. So I declare that with her as prime minister and with her joining with the church, she will bring and we will bring Barbados to the position where we will experience all that God has called us to do and all that he has spoken of the church. So I declare, Barbados is a place where God's spirit will be, where he will be glorified. Barbados is a breadbasket. Barbados is our brother's keeper. Barbados is a lighthouse. So God, have your way within our government and in this nation. Amen.
Amen. And Father God, even as has been declared, that Barbados is a bread basket, that it is a lighthouse, Father God. We declare even now that Barbados is also the intercessor for the Caribbean. Father, that we are the ones who will stand in the gap, Lord God. Father, that because of your hand upon this nation, upon the economy of this nation, Lord God, we will be able to provide for those in need throughout the Caribbean, Lord God. Father, whenever crisis hits a nation within the Caribbean, Barbados is one of the first, if not the first, to send arms. It is the first to extend that hand of brotherhood, that hand of fellowship, Father God. For we're the ones to stand in the gap for those in need. So, Father, we declare even now that the economy of Barbados will be as such that we will be able not only to provide for ourselves, but that we will be able to lend to those who are in need. Father, we would not have any need for the IMF or the World Bank. We will have no need for any outside forces of other nations borrowing from them to fuel our economy. Father, we declare even now a spirit of innovation within our business and within our economy to rise up within our nation, Lord God. That this land will be able to provide, will be able to be the lighthouse to shed your fortune, your wealth, your worth throughout the Caribbean, Lord God. Locally, regionally, globally, Barbados will be a lighthouse. We will stand in the gap for those in need. We will provide the resources because we will be receiving our help from you, God. Father, give us insight as we stand on the wall and look out to see those who are in need. Father, by your spirit, as you have said, Lord God, that we will stand in your spirit. We will be in the spirit at all times, being able to see and accommodate those who are in need. Father, Barbados is a lender and not a borrower. We break every tie, every unholy tie, every unholy partnership with nations that will seek to hold us down, Lord God. We break every curse of debtitude to those who would see you to enslave us and ensnare us, Lord. We break it off right now. We break those chains of bondage and we become bond servants of the Most High, Jesus Christ, so that we can stand in Christ and be his servant to all. We will minister to all. Barbados will stand before the Most High God and say to him, this one is for you. This is the one for you, God, because you have appointed us as the intercessor for the Caribbean. In Jesus' name.
Suffer the little children to come unto you and to forbid them not, Lord God. Father, you said, O God, in your word, to raise up a child in the way he shall go, and when he's older, he shall not depart from it. Father, many of us, O God, have not raised up our children in your law or in your word. And so, Father, today we stand before you and we repent. I'm not bringing, Lord God, our children up before you, Lord God, in your word, that they may walk in your word. Father, we stand as intercessors and we repent, oh God, on the behalf of those who have not done according to your word. But God, we are cognizant, Lord God, that your word says that your hands are not short, that they cannot save, and your ears are not heavy, that you cannot hear. So God, today as we call upon you, we lift up our youth before you, mighty God. We ask you, oh God, to stretch forth your hand and to touch our youth, Lord God. Bring them, Lord God, into your counsel. Cause them to know, oh God, that you are the God who leads and directs. My Father, cause them to know, oh God, that they did not come, Lord God, without a purpose. But as you said to Jeremiah, before I knew you, I formed you in your mother's womb. And I ordained you, Lord God. Bring our youth, Lord God, that they may know, oh God, that you are the one who called them with purpose and destiny inside them, Lord God. Father, bring them, Lord God, that they might understand, oh God, that it is only through your purpose that they will know how to walk this journey of life, Lord God. Father, we lift up our youth before you, mighty God. Father, those, oh God, who have not had the parents, Lord God, to guide them, Father, we ask, oh God, that you would send someone, oh God, that would come alongside and mother them, come alongside, God, and father them. Lord God, you said, oh God, that you are a mother, you are a father to the fatherless, Lord God. Mighty God, bring them in, oh God. Stir them by your spirit, God. Father, even as you spoke to Samuel, mighty God, in the nighttime season, Lord God, speak, oh God, to our youth, Lord God, and call them out of their waywardness, mighty God. Father, we lift a crime, oh God, in this nation before you, even as another, Lord God, lost their life today. Mighty God, we arrest that circle of crime. We arrest, mighty God, that chain of crime in this nation. We arrest it in the name of Jesus. We declare that the spirit of violence shall no longer be heard in our streets, mighty God. But we declare, oh God, that the peace of God shall reign in this nation. Shall reign in this nation. Father, we declare, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that the spirit of anger, the spirit of revenge. Lord God, the spirit of God where the gang, Lord God, seeks to retaliate. Father, we curse that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We release the blood of Jesus against it. And we declare, Lord God, it shall not be. It shall not be in this nation any longer. God, we come, oh God, and we declare, Lord God, that your peace shall be in this nation. Father, to the mothers who are losing their sons, to the fathers, Lord God, who are crying out, Father, release your peace. Release your peace to their hearts. Comfort them, Spirit of the living God. Comfort them that they then know, oh God, that you are there and that you stick closer than a brother. Mighty God. God, for those, oh God, who have caused blood, Lord God, to cry out from the earth, Father, we call for justice. We call for justice, mighty God. For Lord, above all, you are a God of justice. You are a God of justice. And so, Father, we call for justice. But Lord God, we declare that even as you, oh God, will move upon the hearts of our youth, Lord God. Father, we declare, oh God, that they will come to you. Lord, that they will put down their guns, mighty God. They will come to you, Lord God. Drawn to you by your spirit, mighty God. Drawn to you, Lord God, to learn of you. Oh God, we lift up our youth before you. Father, we cry out for our youth. Let us not lose any more of them. God, let us not lose any more of them. Let us not lose any more of them. Father, we declare, according to your word, God, you said this nation, Lord God, that your glory shall be in this nation. God, we declare, we decree, mighty God, that as it is in heaven, it is so in the earth, that the word that has been released in heaven, it is released in this nation. Your glory shall be seen in this nation in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord God, that your blood, oh God, shall speak on our behalf. So, Father, we give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. We give you all the glory. We look forward with anticipation, Lord God, and expectation of what you will do in this nation. God, we thank you, oh God, for bringing our youth, Lord God. We thank you, oh God, for bringing them like droves, Lord God. Oh, God, unto you, mighty God. And we bless your name and we glorify you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And amen. Thank you.
wanna see your kingdom here, King Jesus. You're the name we're lifting high, your glory shaking up the earth and sky. Revival, we wanna see your kingdom here. We wanna see your kingdom here. Spirit, break out, break our walls now. Spirit, break out, heaven come down. Spirit, break out, Spirit, break out, break our walls, break our walls, break our walls now. Oh, Spirit, break out, break out of our traditions, Lord, break out, heaven come down. Spirit, break out, Spirit, break out, break out of our fancies, Lord, break our walls, break our walls, break our walls, break our walls, Spirit, break out, heaven come down, heaven come down, Jesus, break out, Jesus.
Father, we thank you for leading New Dimensions to lift this nation before you. Now, God, as we prepare to lift your church before you, lead and direct the New Testament Church of God and the Church of God of Prophecy as they come to lead us in a time of prayer and intercession.
Praise the Lord. Tonight I greet every one of you in the precious name of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, who was sent to this earth by the Father to offer himself a ransom so we can redeem from the curse of sin. Having accomplished his work, when he was here, he called to himself a group of people. It's referred to as the ecclesia, the called out ones. And Jesus said, as the Father sent me, so send I you. The Father sent him to accomplish his task. He finished his task, and then he said to his followers, I have to go back. I have to go back. I am sending you in my stead. As the Father sent me, so send I you. But Jesus recognized that the church could not effectively minister in this world in its own human strength, intellectually, physically, or in any human dimension. And he said to his followers, go to the upper room and wait until you be endued with power from on high. The church of Jesus Christ will be totally incapable of receiving a baton from him except having received the anointing power of the Holy Spirit to do the work. And he said to them, he gave them a mandate that was vast, probably eclipsing anything they could envisage. He said, I want to go into all the world. This world where evil and wickedness is dominant. This world where people are languishing in sin and depravity. He said, I want to go into all the world and to preach this gospel, but you're going to need the power of the Holy Spirit to do it. And so as we pray tonight, we recognize that just as in the first century, the church needed the Holy Spirit to give direction, to speak, to guide. Our sister made a reference to the fact that we can't do this thing intellectually. And I read the book of Acts that when the apostles were thinking about going to this city and that area and that area, that is what they thought was the right priority of going. But the Spirit intervened and told them that is not where you're supposed to go and give direction. Today, in the context of our world, with the pandemic and all that we are seeing and all that we are observing, with all the distress of nations and perplexity and all of that, we, with our human intellect as the church, will not be able to effectively do the job that we are required to do except through the power of the Holy Spirit. And so I want to pray at this time that God's Spirit would have full sway, that this called out body of people would be people of the Spirit, people led by the Spirit, filled with the Spirit, being led into all truth. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we come to you in the name of your exalted Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who even now is seated at your right hand. Father, you sent him here on a mission. When his mission was completed, before he left, he said to his church, to his followers, as the Father sent me, so sent I you. We acknowledge, oh God, that we have been called by you and sent to take the gospel to the world. But Lord, we acknowledge tonight, as your servant Paul wrote, that we are not sufficient of ourselves to think anything of ourselves, but our sufficiency is of you. And so we pray, oh God, that your Holy Spirit, oh God, would fill us. That your Holy Spirit, oh God, would be given free reigns in us. That we, oh God, be submissive to your Holy Spirit. That he will be able, oh God, to direct us and to redirect us. To guide us, to empower us, to oh God, to tell us where to go, when to move. We pray, oh God, as the Spirit move in the church, in the wilderness, that as the fire, oh God, the fire move by night, oh God, and the cloud move by day, that we are God, like the children of Israel, that we will be submissive to you, that we are God, will look to you and allow your Holy Spirit, who was sent to guide us into all truth, to reveal to us, oh God, the things of you, the Father and the Son. Oh God, it will give us power for service. We pray, oh God, for a fresh anointing of your Spirit upon the church. Oh God, you said, ask of me, rain in the days of the latter rain, and I shall send bright clouds. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, who spoke the early church and said, the time will come when you will no longer have to ask me, but you will be in position to ask the Father. Father, we ask of you for the outpouring of the latter day rains upon the church. We pray, oh God, for the anointing, a fresh anointing, oh God, upon your people. As you use the early church, oh God, to turn the dead world upside down, we pray for a fresh outpouring of the Spirit of God upon your people, that you will lead us, oh God, to the places that we ought to go, that you will direct us, oh God, to the areas that you will lead us strategically, that you will give us direction. Oh God, we will be so sensitive that wherever you want us to go, that we will be submissive, oh God, to you, and we will say yes. When you want us to go to the cities, oh God, or to the way that where, oh God, calls fit, or the way of Gaza, oh God, or wherever you want us to go, that we will be submissive to your Holy Spirit. Spirit of God, have your own way. Lord, your thoughts are higher than our thoughts, and your ways are higher than our ways. Help us, oh God, to resign ourselves to our own thinking, our own thoughts, oh God, that we will submit to the leading of your Holy Spirit, because with you, oh God, we'll be effective. We saw, Lord, on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit was poured out, oh God, you turned a handful of people into a mighty combined harvesting group. We pray, oh God, your Spirit will transform us from a weak, feeble people, a people, oh God, are feeble and incapable of accomplishing anything in ourselves, and that you will take hold of us, that as we stand to declare your word, we will stand in boldness. We will stand in confidence. We pray, oh God, in the apostles' prayer, oh God, that by an anointing of the Holy Spirit, that you will grant that with all boldness, that we will speak your word, and that signs and wonders be wrought in the name of your Holy Child Jesus. We pray as we go forward, declaring your word, that you, oh God, will embed in us, that we are called to be a missional church, a church that will not sit down, but a church that in the militancy of the Holy Spirit will, oh God, go forward, oh God, to pull down the strongholds of the enemy. That we will go forward, oh God, to declare victory, oh God, in the name of Jesus, to set the captives free, oh God, to set those that are bruised, and, oh God, and those that are oppressed, and those that are in prison, oh God, to see them liberated by the power of your Holy Spirit. And so we submit to you. We admit in ourselves we are nothing. But you, oh God, with your Spirit anointing us, you are able to make us able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we are able to ask or think. And so tonight we say, Lord, we say yes to you. We submit to you. We lay our own human strategies, our own human formulas, our own human, oh God, approaches. Oh God, we bow ourselves in submission, and we submit to you, and we say, Holy Spirit, lead us. Holy Spirit, direct us. Holy Spirit, empower us, and use us, oh God, as your instruments to win this harvest, to win this harvest, to reap this harvest for the glory of God and the honor of your Son, Jesus Christ. And Lord, help us that after you've used us, that we will humble ourselves, and like you said, that we will smite ourselves on the chest as you use us, and say, Lord, we are only miserable offenders, that we have only done what you've asked us to do. Deliver us from pride, from arrogance, from a desire for glory. Oh God, it's self-aggrandizement and recognition and position. Oh God, and being want all the things that the flesh, oh God, will rise up in us. We pray, oh God, you will kill the flesh in the church. We pray, oh God, you will sanctify us from worldliness. Halamoka sheep, moki aboshapa. Yalamoki primu sheep abakoshi. Yalamoko makasha. Oh God, cleanse us. Cleanse us, oh God. Sanctify us by the blood. Oh God, help us to renounce sin. Renounce the flesh. Renounce the world, oh God. And as you said to your servant, the Apostle Paul, hallelujah, have you work in us that we will just submit to you. We pray that church become, oh God, a mighty threshing machine. We pray against every strategy of the enemy to hinder us. We declare, oh God, tonight that no weapon as the church, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. And every tongue that rises up against us shall be condemned. Oh God, we declare tonight, hallelujah, that as the Father sent you and you sent us, you said all power and authority is given to me in heaven and on earth. And you have given, oh God, the church that authority, oh God, to defeat the powers of darkness. Oh, hallelujah. And so we submit to you. Have your own way, oh God. And as we go far, remind us, Holy Spirit, remind us, hallelujah, that, oh God, upon this rock, Lord, you said, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. We pray the obstacles of the enemy will be turned into stepping stones. We pray the walls the enemy set up against us will give you, oh God, the opportunity to glorify yourself as you did for Israel, and that your supernatural power working in us, oh God, will cause to see the, all the walls, the massive walls that seem so impenetrable, to see them humble, to see them crumble, oh God. As we submit to you and as we are led to you, we pray when the enemy comes in one way, oh God, to the power of the Holy Spirit, the enemy sent running in all directions, oh God, and that your name will be glorified. We pray like Rachel tonight. Oh God, some of our churches have become barren. Some of our churches, oh God, are going through stagnation. But we pray like Rachel prayed tonight, oh God, in her barrenness. She came to a place where she couldn't take it anymore. And she said, Lord, give me child or I die. I pray, oh God, that this same, oh God, spirit will fill us. That we like Rachel will come to a place where we say, Lord, we can't stand here anymore. Lord, we can't stay buried anymore. Lord, we can't just sit back and be ridiculed anymore. So give us child, oh God. Give us children, oh God, lest we die. Stir us. Stir us. Stir us, oh God, and touch the womb of the church, that we will bring forth twins and triplets and quadruplets, oh God, and that children will be born into the kingdom, oh God, to bring glory and honor to you. We ask for a fresh outpouring again in the name of Jesus. And as we go forth, I pray, oh God, in this time of pandemic, that the church will be the church. Oh God, be your representative in the earth, salt and light. In the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we thank you. We thank you. For you touch them, we pray according to your will. You will do it. And so we give you thanks and praise tonight for what you have done, what you are doing, and what you will do in the church and to your people. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In the mighty and powerful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we humble before you at this hour. We thank you, God, because your word declared unto us that upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church of the living God. Father, as we come as one, even now, God, we ask, even now, God, that you will forgive us. We ask, Lord, that you will forgive us, Lord, as we repent, oh God. Repent, oh God, for being there, God, the dynamic church that you have called us to be. Repent, dear God, for failing to read your word, hiding your word in our hearts. Repent this there, Lord, Heavenly Father, for failing to walk in your word, Father, in the name of Jesus. Repent, dear God, for failing, oh God, to pray and petition you as we ought to, Father. Repent this evening, Lord, as our Father, for failing, dear God, to be the light and the salt that you have called us to be. Jesus. Repent, dear God, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, for misrepresenting you on this earth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father. Because, God, you have given us an assignment as your church, Father. Because, Father, you will not move an eye. You will not bat a hand, oh God. You will not do anything, oh God, unless we as your people petition you, Father, in the name of Jesus. So even now as we humble before you, oh God, we ask even now that you will forgive us, oh God. You will forgive us, oh God, for the sins of omission. You will forgive us, oh God, for the sins of commission. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we ask it, oh God, that you restore us, oh Father. We ask it, oh God, that you revive us, oh God. We ask it, oh God, that you renew us unto yourself in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father. And Lord, we thank you for doing it even now, God. Can we recognize, oh God, that we cannot, oh God, accomplish the work, dear God, and the ministry that you have given unto us, oh God, if we are weak, Father, and insignificant, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, sir. But we declare this evening in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, that we shall arise, oh God, as your people. We shall arise, oh God, as God, a people of purpose, oh God. We shall arise even now, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, with your anointing in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you even now, oh God, for forgiving us. We thank you, oh God, for washing us, oh God. And we thank you even now, oh God, for opening our spiritual eyes, oh God, that we'll be able to see, oh God, who we are on this earth, oh God. We'll be able to see, oh God, the power that you have given unto us, oh God, to represent you, oh God. The power you have given unto us, oh God, to lay hands, oh God, at individuals and they receive healing. The power that you have given unto us, oh God, to cast out devils in the mighty name of Jesus. The power that you have given unto us, oh God, to speak the word in season and out of season in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, oh God. So, Father, as we come before you, even now, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, we claim, oh God, everything that the enemy have taken from us. We claim back, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We claim back, oh God, a desire and a love for your word. We claim back, oh God, a desire to pray and petition you, oh God. We claim back, oh God, the joy of the Lord is our strength, oh God. We claim back, oh God, holiness in the mighty name of Jesus, Father. Hallelujah, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And even now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we take authority over every plan of the adversary of souls. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And Father, we declare even now, oh God, that we are your representative, and we shall arise in the mighty name of Jesus. We shall arise, oh God, from our slumber, oh God. We shall arise and be counted on this earth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We shall arise, oh God, and allow our lights, oh God, to be salt and light, oh God, and to win souls for your kingdom in the mighty and powerful name of Jesus. And we pray this evening, oh God, that even tonight, oh God, even tomorrow, oh God, and the rest of the days, that you will remind us, oh God, Heavenly Father, of the mission and the assignment that you have given unto us on this earth in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the fact remains, oh God, that we stand before you one day, you're going to ask us, oh God, what did we do, Father? What did we do, oh God, with what we have eternal value in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth? So, Father, even now, we give you the honor, we give you the praise. Thank you for washing, thank you for cleansing, thank you for sanctifying, thank you for renewing us, oh God. Because if we are going to walk, oh God, in your power and in your anointing, Father, surely in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, we need, oh Father, a revival. We need, oh God, a renewing. We need, oh God, Heavenly Father, for you to move upon our heart by your Holy Spirit. So, Father, we give you thanks and we give you praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Father, we come to you with sensitive and open hearts, and we pin our faith in the prayer of the Lord Jesus Christ, that answered prayer that said that he would be in us, that the glory that he had with you would be shared with us. And so we come to you and we ask you, O God, for unity. We ask, O God, that our understanding of what it means to be one body would deepen, our understanding of what it means to be indwelt with the same Spirit would deepen, oh God, that we would be united. We pray, oh God, that our understanding of what it means to serve one Lord would deepen. We pray, oh God, that our understanding of what it means to be in Christ, to be immersed in Christ, to be baptized in Christ would deepen. We pray, oh God, that our understanding of who you are and the fact that you are in each and every one of us, that you will work through each and every one of us. May we deepen in this understanding. Oh God, we pray not only for unity, but for maturity. We pray, oh God, that in your church, the gifts will be evident again. The apostolic gift, oh God, that sets and lays a foundation and reaches unreached geographic and demographic groups will be in our church. The prophetic gift, oh God, that will speak forth your will and your word in context will be in our church. The gift, the care for the flock, the pastoral. The gifts of teaching, of proclaiming your word, the evangelical gifts. We pray, oh God, that these will be in our church again so that we be built up, so that we be mature. And not only for unity, not only for maturity, but we pray, Father, that we would reflect your glory. We pray, oh God, that we would bear fruit. We pray that we would understand your love, oh God, its height that it raises up to us to. It's depth, oh God, the depth that your love will go to claim us. It's width that will claim every man for Christ. And so, Father, may we deepen in a love that rejoices, a love that is peaceable, at peace with one another, a love that desires to do good to one another, a love that is faithful with one another, a love that is kind to one another, a love that is gentle to one another, a love that bears with one another. Father, may this be a reality in our churches. And as we reflect your love, oh God, may we fulfill the mandate that has been prophesied. The fact that the knowledge of the glory of the Lord cover the earth, as the waters cover the sea. Lord, as we reflect your character, your very being, oh God, may the knowledge of the glory of the Lord cover this nation, cover this region, cover this earth to us. In Jesus' name, amen.
As we wait, Lord God, we know you will answer. As we wait in your presence, Lord, we know you will answer, Lord. We wait.
to walk in the room. Here we are. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Shekinah glory come down. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Release, release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Glory come, you move, and we want more, you speak, and we want more, you move, and we want more, we want the fullness.
Spirit, Lord, as we pray for the family, as Victory Pentecost and United Holy Church of America. Come on, as they come, let us cry out to God to release His fullness. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. For He has given us freedom. Hallelujah. Oh, Shekinah glory come. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the book of Genesis, as we continue to give God worship and celebrate Him, God created this universe and everything that is in it. The Bible tells us that we are His people and the sheep of His pasture. And the very first institution that God established in His creation was the family. And so tonight, let us join our hearts as we continue the celebration to bring families before You. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before You on behalf of the families tonight. I come before You specifically on behalf of single parents tonight. Hallelujah. Single parent mothers and single parent fathers. As the challenges of life as we go forward in this age, dear God, present themselves. The children have needs. The family have needs. There's so many needs that need to be attended, dear God, in the name of Jesus. We pray for strength tonight and wisdom and guidance for single parents. Hallelujah. It is not an easy task. It is not a trivial task, but one that should be taken with uttermost importance, one that must be taken with a discipline, because the children are Your heritage, Lord, and we are responsible for them. We are responsible for their bringing up. We are responsible for teaching them, for introducing them to You, for raising them up in the ways that they should go and according to Your word. When they grow old, hallelujah, they will not depart. Tonight we come, dear God, are the teachings of the Apostle Paul to families, that fathers will not provoke their children, even in the times when things get harder. Frustration might be on every hand, but the provocation, dear God, will make matters worse. So we come against it tonight. We come against those mothers, dear God, that would want to bring their children to a destitute place and to force them, dear God, into circumstances that will bring their demise. But tonight we lift them up. We pray, dear God, in the name of Jesus, that they will look to You for everything that they need, for You are the supplier of all. You are Jehovah Jireh to the family tonight, and You can provide all of their needs according to Your riches in glory by Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank You, Lord.
Father, the children have many requests. The children are faced with the signs of technology. Their children are faced with their wants and their needs. And even in trying to discover who they are, their aspirations grow very, very, very quickly. And they see things and their hearts are set upon them. And the beauty of all that they see, behold their heart, dear God. But we pray tonight that the children will learn wisdom, that the parents will teach them wisdom, that everything that glitters is not gold. And everything that they see might not be readily accessible, but everything comes with a cost. It may be a sacrificial cost. It may be a cost, dear God, of a tangible means, but that they will know that You, dear God, Your bank does not run out. There are many talents and skills within their families, that even as unemployment is brewing at the doorstep of single parents tonight, both fathers and mothers will look within themselves for the talents and the gifts and seek another way to provide for their families. For Your word have also said that a good man leaves an inheritance for his children and his children's children. But that inheritance doesn't have to be a tangible one. That there are respectable values that need to be taught. That children will understand that there's hard work and there's discipline and self-respect and a high resolution, dear God, to acknowledge the true and living God as a means of going forward in the name of Jesus. And so tonight we pray for their sustenance. We pray for their help. We pray for their guidance. We pray for the communities that they're living in, dear God, that people will be responsible and take the charge to raise our children, that they will be future products of this society and future heirs and joint heirs to the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the
Hallelujah.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you tonight. We thank you for family.
Hallelujah.
Family is important, God. You originated family from in the Garden of Eden, where you joined Adam and Eve together. My God, tonight, as we come before you, in no other name but the name of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, throughout your word tells us about family. Wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands. Husbands, love your wives. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. And parents, don't lead your children to wrath. My God, when we look at Ephesians and Colossians, we see these. Even in the Old Testament, dear Lord, as a man married a wife, he stood home for a whole year to be with his wife. But today, dear Lord, we are seeing the family being divided. But tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ, we rebuke that division spirit is coming upon family.
Hallelujah.
If you declare and you instituted family, it shall be a family. But we know, God, that the enemy is a divider. And he's dividing families all over. Tonight, we come against the spirit of divorce, oh God. Tonight, we know that this COVID-19 is sending people wild. But tonight, we can turn every disappointment into a blessing. Tonight, dear Lord, as families look to you in the name of Jesus, I know, oh God, that there are times when families come home and they don't have time for one another. But in this COVID-19, families can get together, oh God, I pray, and they can have some conversations, especially when the country was on lockdown. Oh, dear God, wives can talk to their husbands and husband talks to the wife. In the name of Jesus, and have family games and what's not together. That is what we are praying for tonight. I pray that we would get back to the old time days where wives would be wives and husbands would be husbands and children truly would be obedient to their parents. But today we see a different situation. We see wives not submitting themselves to their husbands. They're doing as they like. Husbands are doing as they like. Children are doing as they like. Everybody got their own room. Everybody got their own TV. Nobody is sitting down at the table holding hands together and praying anymore. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, we declare that all these things would come to naught and that family would be a family again. In the name of Jesus, we come against every lying spirit. We come against every cheating spirit. We come against every unforgiving spirit. Your word tells me that we should not go down, let the sun go down on your wrath. And tonight, dear Lord, for those families, those husbands and those wives who are on the brink of divorce, we pray, dear God, that you would send your spirit and that you would change that around. Instead of division, you would bring them together in the name of Jesus. Family is important, oh God, as it is important to the children. We come against past. We come against fathers who interfere with the children. We come against uncles who interfere with the girl children. We come against sexual immorality. We come against incest. All of these demonic spirits in the name of Jesus, we come against that would divide families, that would destroy families in the name of Jesus. We come against the spirit of suicide, that as families go broke, as family, as the husband is out of work and they're too proud, oh God, the devil takes advantage of that situation and their vulnerability and say the best way out is to kill yourself and to kill your children and your wife. We come against that now in the name of Jesus. For every father, for every mother who are thinking and contemplating about that, we rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, you know who they are. You know where they are. We might not know, but we are praying for that family right now. that is contemplating these things. We are praying for that family who is giving up on you because things might seem bleak. Things seem dark. There's no way out, but there's always a way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And I pray that you would make that way for them when there seems to be no other way. In the name of Jesus, we come against sickness. In the name of Jesus. Oh, make the family a family again, dear God. That's what we are praying for tonight. That the family would be a family. And that the people of the world will see and know what it is to be a family. There are some people when they see families together, Lord, they get jealous because their family is not like that. My God, there are some people out there who don't live in a big house, who don't have a big car, but that family is so contented and so loving because they put you first. That's the important thing tonight, Lord. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else shall be added unto you. And I pray tonight that whatever discouragement, whatever situation or circumstance might come aware of the family, that they will always inquire of you, that they will always put you first in the name of Jesus. Oh my God, I pray that we would understand tonight that as long as we are your children, we would have to go through some situations. We would have to go through some circumstances tonight. But if you put us through it, you will bring us out of it in the name of Jesus. Job lost everything. But in the end, because your word says, those who endure to the end, the same shall be saved. And tonight, I pray for saving grace, that you will save families, and that the family that prays together will stay together in Jesus' name. Amen.
Oh, Father, allow us to approach you, for you are God. Allow me to approach you,
come on now,
because you are the creator of all things. Lord, we come to you tonight for our families. We are fully aware that this was the first institution that you created back way in Genesis. And Father, everything that you have touched will stand. It seems to us that the family today has become dysfunctional.
All right.
But because you have ordained it,
yes,
it will stand.
In the name of Jesus.
No demon,
no
devil from hell can destroy your work.
No, Lord.
And Father, tonight we come, though unworthy, to petition you for the families of this island in particular.
Yes, Lord.
For the families of the world.
Yes, Lord.
Because we are fully aware that from families come society.
Come on.
From society come governments.
Mm-hmm.
And Lord, we look to you for help. We need help right now in this nation. And we look to you from whence cometh our help. You are able and well able to do it. And Lord, you know every one of us by name and by nature.
Mm-hmm.
You know what we need. And Father, you have provided for us. And even in times of scarcity, you have provided for us. We are still standing. We are still standing as families. We are still standing as a church. And we give you thanks. Right now, I lift up my hands to you.
Yes.
Because of who you are. You're God. And you're God alone. And sometimes from our perspective, it seems that all is lost and that we are failing. And by your spirit, we have a new brand's perspective. The perspective that we have is we will be victorious. The perspective we have, we will always be among the conquerors. Lord, we give you thanks.
We give you thanks. We are not embracing the negatives, but we are embracing you.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus Christ himself. Mm-hmm. And Lord, it all is through the blood.
Yes.
You give us your spirit, mm-hmm. but we access you through the blood.
Yes, Lord.
The blood that was shed on Calvary for every Lord. One of us. Yes. And we tonight believe with all our hearts that tomorrow for all families
yes.
will be a better tomorrow.
Come on.
We are victors. The devil has been defeated. And we know he has been defeated. Tomorrow will be brighter.
Yes.
Tomorrow will be more wholesome. It may not look like it, but it is not how it looks like. It is what you say from your word. It's your word. And we hold on to your word because your word is a sure word. Give us right now contentment. Give us now peace. Give us now direction. We love you because you are God. We follow you because you are the guide. We look to you for providence. Because you are the provider. We look you, Lord, for sustenance because you are the sustainer. And Father, with you among us, with you in us, with you in us, your spirit is dwelling in us. And as long as you dwell with us, everything will be all right. And Lord, right now I give you all the preeminence, I give you all the glory, and I give you all the praise. You are who you said you are. You are God. And you are God alone. Father, accept these petitions. Accept all requests. Keep us in you. Guide us. Protect us. Shield us. And most of all, plant your word. And your spirit in our hearts. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. And amen.
Amen. As we sing this song, we declare that the walls that stood around us will come down. The walls of financial trouble, the walls of sickness, the walls of pain, the walls that we've prayed about. We declare as we sing, we prophesy in the atmosphere that these walls will come down. Hallelujah. Some of them we would have thought would have been down by now. But the song where they said, walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall. But you have never failed me yet, church. He's never failed us. Amen. Hallelujah. And he will never fail us. Thank you, Jesus. We worship him. Thank you, Lord. Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall. But you have never failed me yet. Yeah. Waiting for change to come. Knowing the battle's won. For you have never failed me yet. Promise still stand. Great is your faithfulness. Your faithfulness. I'm still in your hand. This is my confidence. You never fail me. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Your
atmosphere, walls shall fall. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Come on, church. Lift your voice, lift your hands. Walls are falling. Walls are falling. Walls. Hallelujah. We believe that God can move. He can move the mountain of COVID-19.
God, we exalt your name tonight, oh God. Father, we say, Lord, that you are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords. Father, you are powerful, God. You are majestic. And Father, Lord, tonight we stand, God, in the understanding, oh God, Lord, that we have seen you move in time before. And God, tonight we believe, oh God, that you are more than able, Lord, to do exceedingly, God, abundantly above all, Lord, that we can ask, think, or imagine. Lord, tonight we stand. Lord, tonight we agree. Lord, because we know the power of intercession. Lord, we know that your word says, God, that one may chase 1,000. Hallelujah. But God, too, will put 10,000 to flight. So, God, tonight we stand, Lord, knowing that the effectual fervent prayer, Lord, of a righteous man, God, it availeth much. And God, as we come before you tonight, oh God, Lord, I want to lift all those who are currently sick as a result of COVID-19. Lord, those who are in the quarantine center. Lord, those who are in a hospital bed tonight. Lord, those who are on the ventilators. Lord, those who the doctors are saying that they will not make it. Father, tonight we stand, Lord, with the power and the understanding, oh God, knowing that there is still power in your name. Lord, knowing tonight, Father, God, that healing, oh God, is still, oh God, in your word. And we stand tonight, God, knowing that healing, God, is the children's bread. We stand tonight, God, knowing how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, and wherever he went, he was healing, he was delivering, and he was canceling and casting out every unclean spirit. And Father, tonight we pray right now in the same name of Jesus, in the same power of the Holy Ghost. We stand, God, with that authority, and we decree and we declare, Lord, that you are touching their bodies right now. Every pain, God, every discomfort, Lord, every sickness, Lord, we command it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ to dry up in the name of Jesus. Tonight, God, we decree and we declare that what Satan has meant for evil, Lord, tonight we say hallelujah, God, that you are turning it around, Lord, for our good. So, Father, we release the healing anointing right now, Lord, in the quarantine center right now. We release the healing anointing, Lord, to those who are in isolation, oh God. Lord, not only locally, regionally, God, and internationally, we release the power of the Holy Ghost, Lord, to come upon their immune system. And God, everything that is out of alignment, we command it tonight to hear the word of the Lord. We command it tonight to come into alignment. Lord, we speak to their bodies, and we say, God, in the image and in the likeness in which you have created it, Lord, it shall function in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we can see now in our island, God, 49 persons still in isolation, oh God. Father, we release the healing anointing in all of them, oh God.
And we decree and we declare, God, that they shall recover and come back into mainstream society, Lord, with a testimony that it was not the nurses, it was not the doctors, but it was the Lord that touched me and healed me, and I'm alive today only because of his grace and his mercies. So Father, we pray right now, God, Lord, that this is an avenue, Lord, for those who are currently facing COVID-19, an avenue, God, that they would cry out to you, Lord, a channel that they would call upon you. Lord, I pray that when they call upon you, Father, you would show yourself strong and you would let them know, God, that it's only in the name of Jesus Christ, it's only in our God that they can receive healing from any sickness, oh God. So Father, we uproot it tonight. Father, we cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, every attack, God, Lord, every javelin, Lord, whatever was released against their lives in this season, Father, we curtail it at its root in the name of Jesus Christ, oh God. And we decree and we declare tonight, God, Lord, it is well with their soul. Father, we ask right now that you would even touch, Lord, Lord, those in India right now, Father. We ask, God, that you would have mercy upon them, oh God. We pray, God, that that situation, Lord, will turn around right now, and we release the healing anointing over the entire universe. We decree and we declare that that which Satan has meant for evil, God, you are turning it around for your good, and we release it tonight. We say, God, that by your stripes, they are healed in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I want to invite you to stand as we pray for our government. We pray for the medical workers. We pray for those who are frontline workers. And we pray for world economy. I just want you to begin to call on the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Just begin to open your mouth and call on the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you that you are Jehovah, that you are the God who is, the God who will be. We thank you, Father, that you are the omnipotent God and that there is nothing that is too hard for you. We thank you, Almighty God, that you are able to overcome COVID, that before COVID was, God, you were. You are the eternal God, the infinite God, the all-powerful God. We thank you, Almighty God, for your grace, and we thank you, Almighty God, for your mercy, and we thank you, oh God, for extending your hand toward us in the name of Jesus. And Father, at this time, we lift our government before you. Lord God, we lift, Father, the Prime Minister and those in authority over us. We pray, Almighty God, that you would give them wisdom concerning, Father, how to deal with this issue of COVID. We thank you, oh God, for the things that you have done in this nation. We thank you, Almighty God, for protecting lives, Almighty God. We knew that the situation could have been worse, but God, in your mercy, you have helped us. And we pray, God, for divine help, divine counsel. Lord God, may they not lean, God, unto their own understanding, but may they look to you in the name of Jesus. We pray, Father, that you would continue to help them. Lord God, develop strategies that would help see us through this pandemic in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray, Lord, for those that have been working on the front lines. Lord God, we thank you for your protection, mighty God. We thank you for putting your hand around them and over them in the name of Jesus. And we pray, God, that you will continue to protect them, that you will continue to extend your hand of mercy toward them, Almighty God. We pray, Father, that you will protect them from contracting COVID. May their hearts, Lord God, not be afraid. May they not, oh God, be anxious, but may they recognize, Lord, that they can put their trust and their confidence in you. May they recognize, Almighty God, that you are a present help in the time of trouble and you are with them, Lord. May they know, God, that you have not abandoned them, you have not forsaken them, but you have been with them, God. You have been their help. You have been their shelter. You have been their hiding place, Almighty God. So as they continue, Father, to deal with this, we pray, Almighty God, that you will indeed put a hedge of protection around them and around their families in the name of Jesus. God, give them the grace, give them the mercy that they need to effectively minister to those who are afflicted with COVID, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus. Let your hand be upon them, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Father, we pray, God, that you would give economic initiatives. We know, Father, that the government is preparing to open back the country. And Lord, we don't know, God, what the implications will be. But we are praying, Father, that your hand of protection will rest upon this island. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God, that you will protect, God, those who work in the hotels, that you will protect those who work in the supermarkets, those who work in our places of attraction. We pray, oh God, that you will protect them, Almighty God. God, we thank you, Lord, that there is medical intervention, but our hope is not, God, in a vaccine. Our hope is in the Lord Jesus Christ, the God who is Jehovah Rapha, the God who is able to heal. And Father, as a people, may we humble ourselves before you, oh God. God, and may we look to you. I pray, Father, that we will not be proud, mighty God, and we will not elevate, God, our own wisdom, but we will turn to you, Almighty God, in this season. God, may we learn to call upon the name of Jesus, as even as it was in the Old Testament, God, where you demonstrated that you were Lord. I pray once again that you will move in our nation and you will show that you alone are the true and living God, and you are the God who hears and answers prayer. So Father, we are praying that you would extend your hand of mercy towards this nation in the name of Jesus, and may we put our trust and our confidence in you. Lord, we pray, God, for governments around the world, that Lord, you will stimulate economic initiatives in Jesus' name. You know, Father, that there are businesses that have gone under, but Father, we are praying that you will turn the financial situation around. We are praying, Father, for creativity and innovation, and ideas will emerge, God. We are also praying for a spirit of generosity, that Father, those that have will share, Lord God, their resources, that there will be no selfishness in Jesus' name. Lord God, we pray for our Christian businesses in Jesus' name. We lift them before you, and we pray, God, that even as Isaac sold in the midst of famine, that God, as they soul and they put their trust and confidence in you, that God, you would cause them to prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, we are asking for your intervention around the world. Lord, we pray for the poor, we pray for the disenfranchised, we pray for the vulnerable, and we ask you, oh God, to take care of them. May they look to you and put their trust and confidence in you. Mighty God, may you supply supernaturally. May you open doors of favor and blessing in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, may you turn this economic situation around. And Father, where it seems that all is bleak, where men's hearts are failing, we pray, oh God, that as they put their trust and confidence in you, that doors of provision will become available to them in the name of Jesus. And so, Father, we thank you, Almighty God. We thank you for your intervention. We thank you, oh God, for giving the government the wisdom and the direction and the counsel that they need. And we come, God, against every ungodly counsel in the name of Jesus. We come against, God, any spirit of corruption right now in Jesus' name. And we pray, Father, that indeed you will superintend this process and you will bring restoration, God, to our country in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, for economic restoration in the name of Jesus. God, send what needs to be sent, God, and stir the hearts of the people of God, that we will come up with initiatives that our country might be blessed and indeed can God bless other nations. And Father, even as we gave to St. Vincent, mighty God, and we have given to other nations, Father, we declare that that is seed, and even as it has gone forth, we are praying, God, that you will multiply the returns to this nation, Father, that we can continue, God, to be a blessing to nations, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Almighty God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
Amen. For the earth is the Lord's, and the fullness, and the thereof. Fullness thereof. Hallelujah. And those and they that dwell therein. Hallelujah. Father, we declare you are sovereign over this land.
Yes, God. Yes.
And we declare that you are sovereign over the earth.
Yes, yes.
Lord, COVID-19 has not displaced your sovereignty.
Yes.
Lord, COVID-19 has not changed your rule or your authority.
Thank you, Almighty God. Thank you.
COVID-19 has not brought into question your governorship.
Yes, you are still Lord.
COVID-19 cannot move, God, and control your response, because you don't respond to COVID-19. Father, you have been before COVID-19.
Yes, yes, yes.
Lord, we don't need to cry out to you for you to look within yourself for wisdom. But Father, we cry out to you for you to have your way in this earth. For the earth is yours, O God. And Father God, while we may not understand why this has been allowed to happen, Lord, we understand that you are in charge and you are in control. And Father, we choose to trust you even in the midst of it looking, Lord, doubtful, in the midst of it looking bleak, in the midst of thousands of deaths and millions of sickness. Lord, we still choose to trust you. Father God, we trust you in the morning time, and we trust you in the evening time, and we trust you in the night time. God, we trust you when the economy seems to be tittering and tottering. God, we trust you. God, when we look at Trinidad, we still trust you. Lord, even when hospital beds are filling up, we trust you. And God, we trust that there's a deeper work, there's a deeper move at work here, God, than what is presenting on the surface. And Lord, as the people of God, we don't enter into arguments over where COVID came from and whether it was manufactured or whatever. Lord, we understand it is here. And Lord, we cry out to you not only for healing, we cry out to you not only for economic repair and economic recovery, but God, we cry out to you for spiritual revival. Lord, we cry out to you, God, because as pressure is applied to the earth, like pressure will be applied to the olive or pressure applied to the grape, we pray, God, that the oil will come out and that the juice will come out, Father, that Lord, we will be sweeter, Lord God, in you, that as we spend time in lockdown, as we face our own failings and our own shortcomings, we pray, Holy Spirit, that you will move at the level beginning with the household of faith first, and we will cry out to you, and we will say, oh God, have mercy, oh God, have mercy, not only on our lives, but have mercy, God, in our circumstances. Lord, we are praying that the after COVID-19 leave this place, that Lord, not only will there be a revival, but God, we are praying there'll be reformation across the globe in the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying that the church will rise up in power and march against the gates of hell, for your word says that the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. And so, God, may we move in power to call forth souls that are lost and locked behind the gate. I pray, God, that we, as we surrender in this time, Lord, that we will return to the basics. That Holy Spirit, you will rule supreme in the church again. And you will rule supreme in the land again, because we have come to the end of ourselves. We have come to the end of ideas. We have come to the end of innovation. It is all good, but it must come to an end. And when we end, God, that's when you begin. And so God hasten us to come to the recognition that we are incomplete. But you are complete. And we are full and safe in you. So, Lord, as the church, this weekend of Festival of Pentecost, we release, Lord God, back to you, which was always yours, the earth, fullness thereof, the people, they that dwell therein. And I pray, God, that we will look upon COVID like you look upon sin, a universal problem requiring divine intervention. So heal us not only of COVID, but heal us of disobedience. Heal us of not walking according to your spirit. Cleanse us and make us right again in the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, we thank you for being with us this evening. We thank you, God, for everything that you have done. Thank you, God, for every prayer offered. God, thank you for the word spoken. Thank you, Lord God, for every song lifted. Thank you, Lord, for the leadership of this house and the members and all of the staff. Thank you for the technical team, God, everyone who made this evening possible. Thank you for our administrative bishop, Bishop Kenroy, and all of the other bishops and those who serve on the Festival of Pentecost Committee. Bless them, God. Lord, as we transition from this night of intercession to looking on the youth tomorrow, God, would you move tomorrow? Lord, would you have your way tomorrow? Lord, would you touch tomorrow? Lord, would you speak tomorrow? Lord, would you anoint? Would you rescue? Would you empower? Would you set the young people on fire for you? Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, as we gather at New Dimensions tomorrow, Lord, run ahead of us. Meet us there before 6. Lord, be there, God, and have your way. Lord, as we come to celebrate on Sunday at 5 at Abundant Life, have your way again. Anoint the speakers. Anoint everything that is said and done. God, to you be the glory. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, God, for every denomination that has come together. I thank you, God, for every church that has partnered, Lord. I thank you, God, from Church of God of Prophecy to New Testament Church of God to the United Church of United Holy Church of America to New Dimensions to PAWI. Lord, I thank you, Lord. And we give you the glory. And we are awaiting for your spirit to break out. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you. Thank each and every one of you for coming. May he take you home in peace and safety. I'm not too sure if Bishop Burke wants to say anything. He doesn't have that anointing look this evening. He's saving it for Sunday. But I want to remind you, please spread the word. We are meeting tomorrow at New Dimensions Ministry, 6 p.m. For the youth, and then Sunday at Abundant Life Assembly, 5 p.m. for celebration of Pentecost. Bless you. Get home safely. It's wonderful.